Okay, how big was that win on Saturday?
Well, they're all big now, but since, you know, Tulane hadn't won in Memphis and who knows how long, that it was big. And where we're fighting for right now, you know. It, you know, it's two or three teams. We're all sitting kind of right there. And, you know, not many people are going to win in Memphis. So it's almost like, you know, getting two wins, to be honest with you. So it's a big win for us. But now every game you play, you're down about seven games left. And every one of them are like an NCAA tournament game right now for us.
Were you aware that it's been 40 years since you swept there? Swept them?
No, didn't know that. And let me, Ryan, check 40 years, just in case I want to go through some negotiations or something. I may need that information.
I'll be your agent.
No,
you,
okay? No.
I'll only take 5%.
I appreciate that 5%, but I wasn't here 40 years ago. I have no idea what happened 40 years ago from then, but I'm just happy that we were able to win that game.
So what about Cincinnati? I know that it was a very hotly contested game the last time you played up there, right?
Yeah, that's what I say about our league. I mean, whether it's Cincinnati, Wichita, or Houston, and I mean, every game's a big game in this league. And, you know, I'm just happy now we're one of the good teams, you know. And it wasn't long ago to, you know, you can come in Tulane and just automatically get a win. Well, I've said before those days are over, we're one of the good teams, and we're all battling for what's going to happen in postseason.
A lot of overtime experience this year, right?
Yeah, last three on the road have been in overtime. You know, again, you know, it's a sign of a good team is that you can win on the road. And that's why I talked about winning 4, 5, 6 games on the road. If you can get that done, then you know you got a good team. And win in different ways, you know. And so the way we won that game and to get in overtime and you know, for T.Y. to make that shot and Forbes to make the – I mean, Cross to make the pass, you just got to have a lot of guys. And we're just having one of those special years right now.
9-2 in the league. You have to be pleased with that, right?
Yeah, we are. But, you know, again, we're not satisfied. You know, we got to just keep playing and just worry about what the next game brings. And we got a good Cincinnati team we've got to play. And you just got to get ready. And these guys are carrying me. It's all about the players. And I'm doing a lousy job of coaching. But I got such great kids and great players. They're picking me up every time, man.
So it's 8-3 in the league, but 9-2 at home. So you have to feel good about your chances here anytime, right?
That's that Loyola math of yours. I have no idea about your math skills, man. You're proving again why you didn't get into Lane. You know, you really are.
Wow.
Hey, you two, you're confusing me. I have no idea. All I know is we need to win this game. That's all I know. I don't know about those other numbers. I think you're trying to trick me.
You think I'm trying to trick you?
I think you're trying to trick me because okay. I'm trying to add all this stuff up okay. And it's not working for me.
Okay, it's like when you go to the cash register and you're trying to quick change them, you know?
Well, even more when they talk about 20%. I got to carry the one. Plus a two, and I just give them more than what they with 20%. So
to get in the tournament, yeah. Do you think you have to win the conference championship?
We just want to win. We want to win as many games as we can. I don't want these guys to worry about and think about what can happen 2 weeks from now, 3 weeks from now. All I know is that we need to win a Cincinnati game. When you start worrying, let everybody else talk about those things. That's just too much. What we want to do is focus on the next game and see what happens at the end. We do know that you can go to the conference tournament. You know, you can win it in the conference tournament. There's a lot of different things that can happen. But right now, let's just worry about playing Cincinnati and winning that game.
So in February, it's easy to get carried away with that too, right?
Oh, it really is. You start to lose focus on everything. And the most important thing is the games. And so, you know, you start looking at all the other things. And we were walking into Memphis, and all they were talking about was their seeding. You know, then you lose a game. You know, and so what you want to do is just worry about what's in front of you right then. This league is too hard enough that you got to start worrying about something 2 or 3 weeks from now.
Something that you have to be better at down the stretch is?
Coaching.
Other than that?
We just got to keep playing, man. We didn't play great at Memphis. You know, we haven't played our best basketball yet. We're playing better. But I can't wait for us when we get to that point when I can say, man, this team's actually peaked. And that's what I'm waiting for. Because when we do that, when the offense and the defense are playing well together on the same day, it's going to be really, really hard to beat us.
You've been able to do that late in the season with teams throughout your career. How does that happen?
That starts in the summer. That's something that we talk about, making sure that we're always playing our best basketball. I know people get a little upset and they say, hey, we lost this early, but everything we do is purposely, because again, if you look, we only play about 7 guys right now, but that's all designed. I've been doing this for the last 15 years playing this way, and all my teams usually play well at this time of year, but that's something that is by design.
The Wichita game, going back to that, was that a real metal tester? I mean, to be able to win that kind of crazy game. Did that help you a lot, you think?
You know, I want to give you a coach's answer, but I can't remember. I'm so old, I can't even remember what I ate for breakfast this morning. So what happened in the Wichita game? I know we won, but what happened? I don't even know what happened.
We won in overtime. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, whatever you say, the answer to that is yes. I have no idea. I can't even remember it. I don't want to sit up on my favorite TV station, make up something, sound like, yeah, well, you know, this. I have no idea, to be honest with you.
Well, the thing is, if you can't remember, why am I here today?
Well, I remember, you know what? I remember that you weren't here last week, and I found out why, and I'm glad that you're healthy and you're doing well. Mm-hmm. So I appreciate that. But, you know, when you get my age at 39, it's really, you start forgetting things at 39.
I took credit for the Wichita victory.
You should have. I appreciate that. You know, the psychology helped. I don't know, since I've sat on that couch, have we lost?
No.
We need to go find that couch again.
I'm all for it.
Let's go find that couch, man.
Thank you, bro.
All right, buddy. Appreciate it.
You want to send somebody over to me?
Yeah.